I'm going to show you how to make a quick and effective smooth locomotion system in Unreal Engine 5 for VR. There weren't any good tutorials when I tried doing it, so I want to save you some trouble and show you in a few minutes what took me days to figure out. A quick overview of what we're gonna do are these four steps. The first step is making two input action files. The second step is to reference them in the default IMC, the input mapping context, basically key binding. The third step is adding movement based on this input in the VRPawn blueprint. And the final step is using the correct camera vector for the world direction. I'm gonna use the VR template project made by Unreal to show you all of this. So first of all, in the content drawer, try to find the input folder. And there you will make one input action file. We'll name it move X for the x-axis. Make sure to change the value type to axis 1D for one dimensional. And add a dead zone modifier too. Then duplicate this file for the y-axis, you just rename it. Now that we're done with this, we go back into the input folder and we enter the IMC default file. Here we're gonna add two mappings for the two inputs that we've just made, one for move X and another for move Y. To explain this better, we're going to use the left thumbstick of the controller for movement, and that is mapped on a two-dimensional graphic with an X and a Y axis, as you can see. The left axis is left to right, and the Y axis is down to up. Both of these have values ranging from minus 1 to 1. Minus 1 being when you move the thumbstick all the way to the left or to the bottom, and 1 when you move it all the way to the top or to the right, allowing for further modification of walking speed based on this. So now we just put in the x-axis of the left thumbstick in the move X mapping. And you press this little plus next to the mappings to add the move Y now. And now we search for the Y axis of the left thumbstick. With the mappings done, we can move on to the blueprint. Type VRPawn in the content drawer and you're gonna find it. And here you can see all the standard stuff for teleportation that you are provided with. And now we're gonna make the movement, continuous movement, that we wanted to make in the first place. Now to do this, right click and type move X, and then click on the enhanced input action for move X. Then right click again and search for add movement input and get that too. And then we just link these two together and link the action value with the scale value, so we have the rate at which we move, how fast we move. And then make the same thing but for move Y. Now onto the final step that gave me the most headaches, and which is the vectors. For the move X, we're gonna use the get right vector from the camera component, and that's important, use the camera component. Now plug it into the world direction that's linked to the move X. And do almost the same thing to the move Y, but instead of getting the right vector, you get the forward vector. What this does is that the forward vector gets where your headset is pointed towards, and the right vector gets where your right side of the headset is pointed towards, altogether making a head-oriented movement that most VR games use now. If you listened all the way to the end and it works for you, I hope this really helped you and saved you some time, because it sure cost me some when I tried to do this myself. So Good luck on your VR game making adventure.